Hello and welcome to the session on life-centered education. Education is one of the most important investments a country can make in its people. It is the most important lever for social, economic and political transformation of a country. Education is identified as a major cause of socio-economic and ethnic conflicts in a country. Education is about developing the whole child. It should therefore aim to foster creative, emotional, moral and spiritual growth as well as intellectual development. Education systems are encountering challenges and changes everywhere. The vital importance of education cannot be denied for any individual, but education usually becomes critical for those with any kind of disability since they are excluded from the mainstream educational process. They experience inequalities in their daily lives and have fewer opportunities to access a quality education that takes place in an inclusive environment. This is because people with disabilities of all types typically need more time to learn and acquire practice skills. Researchers on post-school outcomes of youth and young adults with disabilities have always revealed very disturbing truths throughout the world. Out of those who are a part of special education, only a meager number remain employed. The attitude towards the community or relatives of such disabled is also weird. Such a segment of community tend to have less interaction with the other disabled peers, have no intimate relationships, possess little or no autonomy, participate only in passive leisure activities, etc. Studies also reveal that special education people held low paying jobs and hence needed more daily living, social, recreational and occupational training. Barriers to the learning of students with severe intellectual disabilities can include low expectations, lack of trained teachers, limited family involvement, programming based on developmental models of learning and environments that are highly specialized and not reflective of typical settings. Special need can be defined as anything that requires care or intervention outside of the norm. Some special needs are fairly visible and others are much less obvious. The latter condition is harder to identify and can be more challenging to understand. Traditionally, people who need special care are separated from the mainstream and placed in institutions with specialized education classrooms. Usually, expectations for learning are lower in special education rooms than in regular education for those without disabilities. The most important change in thinking involves the issue of whether these special people should receive education. While past perceptions question the ability of those with severe disabilities to learn, current perspectives support the notion that all individuals can and do learn. The only difference is that the way they learn may vary from the people who do not have any disabilities. Every student with a disability has the right to an appropriate education in the least restrictive environment. When this special segment of people is given the proper environment, quality instruction and support, they learn both academic and non-academic skills. The field of special education has moved from a perspective of caretaking and protecting to an expectation of learning and growth. Children with disabilities should get adequate opportunities to pursue education, which can enable them to get gainful employment in future for leading a life of dignity and respect. Students with severe disabilities can leave the school system and assume meaningful roles in their communities, provided that they are given needed support and encouraged to partially participate in activities. Until such time as there is only one education system and the divisions between general and special education are indistinguishable, responsibilities for ensuring appropriate education to the special segment must be targeted. Curriculum development for the disabled. A growing body of literature suggests that appropriateness of education must be determined in terms of individual needs for dealing with demands of adulthood. A primary purpose of special education is to help students with disabilities to lead successful and personally fulfilling lives. For this to be successful, a functional curriculum is to be designed to prepare them to function as independently as possible in a community setting. The curriculum to prepare the mentally disabled, that is to prepare them intellectually and academically, must be developmentally appropriate and age appropriate. A broad range of skills should be included in the curriculum design appropriate for students with disabilities, whether they are educated in special settings or in regular classrooms with their non-disabled peers. Prior to the 18th century, the majority of physicians and professional educators felt that the effort to educate the disabled segment of the society was futile. The earliest history relating to special education was found during the early 1800s by the European physicians. Jean-Marc Itard was a French scientist and is considered the father of modern special education. His curriculum and instructional approaches included the following: a developmental approach to instruction. The curriculum for such a segregated segment of people was based on the individual's functioning levels. Sensory stimulation. The curriculum was based on basic sensory systems like vision, hearing, smell, taste, tactile, kinesthetic, etc. Functional life curriculum. Here, the curriculum focused on developing living skills within immediate environment. Individualized instruction. The instructional approach was based on the specific needs of the individuals. Systematic instruction. The instruction was based on task analyzed sequences of the skills, beginning with real life and concrete tasks at the child's functioning level. The early 1900s, the training schools for the students with mental retardation became institutions for custodial care. It was obvious at that time that disability of this kind could not be cured with education. The years between 1930s and 1950s saw gradual renewal in the education of the mentally disabled people. In the 1930s, the developmental method became more important, focusing on curriculum composed of hierarchies of task analyzed normal developmental skills in cognition, fine and gross motor communication, social and behavioral, self-help and adaptive skills. One of the common instructional methods used for children and youth with mental disabilities during 1960s and 1970s was behavioral teaching techniques. Age appropriate behaviors in a developmental curriculum included the following: infancy and early childhood ages. This involves sensory motor skills, communication, self-help skills, socialization skills, etc. Childhood and early adolescence. Application of basic academics in daily life activities, application of reasoning and judgment in mastering the environment, social skills, etc. Adolescence and adult life. This includes vocational and social responsibilities and performances of the individuals. Later, the education of individuals with mental retardation focused on essential living skills, which included daily living activities, social skills, and work skills. The skills needed for special education students continued to expand as society became more and more complex. The traditional ways of developing content and curriculum for such a segment of the society through the watering down of the regular curriculum did not work, because they generally dealt with functionally irrelevant knowledge and skills. Some of the major downfalls of the special education students during and after they left the education system were their difficulties in daily living and personal social areas. Thus, the need for a curriculum that took care of these important components became apparent. It was also required that the curricular content should emphasize instruction in such areas as personal responsibility, social competence, interpersonal relationship, health, both physical and mental, employability, occupational awareness, home living, job skills, recreation, and leisure skills. One such curriculum that evolved during that time was the life-centered education. The life-centered education, or LCE, or life-centered career education, LCCE, curriculum involved in the 1970s during the early years of the career education movement that served as the educational reform thrust for all students during that decade. life-centered education. Everyone, regardless of their situation and abilities, has the right to develop a career that is best for them. Curricular models based on the concept of career education emphasize effective participation by the individual in all life's occupations. It thus requires a program that starts early in school career and continues into adulthood. When teaching individuals with severe disabilities, the use of systematic and direct instruction has been highly recommended. A systematic instructional approach consists of a well laid out plan of teaching that involves targeting and evaluating what students can learn, given meaningful opportunities to practice their skills. A frequent question posed by those concerned about career development is that, how can special education students be better prepared to lead productive adult lives and become integrated successfully into their community? Life-centered education is a solution to this diverse problem. The LCE or LCCE is a competency-based approach designed to address the needs of children with learning disabilities, those with mild mental disabilities, and those children who are at risk. Life-centered education include various training programs that provide education and special training to develop various skills that are useful to this challenged segment of society. Much life-centered learning is centered on problem solving. The main focus of LCE is to teach these children or students the skills that are required to live a life that involves independence and freedom. The disabled children are motivated to learn information, skills and competencies that will help them to perform tasks or deals with problems that they face in their everyday life. Different methods are adapted to produce better results among these challenged groups. New knowledge, understandings and competencies are most effectively learned and retained when presented in real life situations. Life-centered education emphasizes on total guidance, personal skills, daily living skills, social skills, occupational skills, all supported by academic skills. It further provides self-determination and employment skills. The curriculum of LCE includes various programs that help students to function independently and productively as family members and citizens. The curriculum provides a lot of flexibility both to trainer as well as students. The process of learning is done with the help of family members and available friends. Systematic instruction stems from both formative and summative forms of assessment that effectively assesses student progress within natural environments and meaningful contexts. Assessment is fundamental to the education decision making process for all students. So, the first and the foremost step in LCE is assessment of the student's capabilities and needs. For students with significant cognitive disabilities, the process of assessing the student's current level of performance in functional, academic and life skills is especially important to identify academic content to be taught and the resources needed. The students are closely observed and various verbal and non-verbal tests are carried out. Assessment data is used both to measure student progress and to provide teachers with important information used to modify and change instructional programs. The teacher, with the help of assessment report, prioritizes the objectives and select intervention activities that best meet the student's current needs. Mastery of specific skills and data on successful intervention strategies are documented. On the basis of such an assessment, a student is given the correct type of training. After the students join the training program, their level of competency is documented. This later leads to the creation of an individual education program designed specifically for them. Brolin's life-centered career education curriculum. Getting a job for anyone is a difficult process. Add a disability and it could be even more difficult. When considering different employment opportunities, general and special educators must consider skills needed by students with disabilities to be successful. People who are disabled, especially mentally challenged, do not often possess the skills and qualifications that are necessary to compete for jobs. Many of these people, due to lack of specialized facilities, are unable to complete their education. The educators and professionals must provide opportunities for such students to develop their academic and social skills. The need for curricula was found to be the most relevant factor needed for meeting the needs of the special education students. Don E. Brolin recognized, developed and evolved the importance of social skills and suggested the use of the life-centered career education model or LCCE that integrates career education into the regular education curriculum using a three-dimensional model. The LCCE was developed at the University of Missouri, Columbia and published in 1978 by the Council for Exceptional Children CEC after Brolin passed away. Brolin states thus, LCCE is a functional skill transition curriculum built on concepts of career development. There are three major features of the LCC model that make it unique and consistent with the transition functional curriculum concept that is currently being promulgated throughout the world. The first thing is that it addresses 22 basic life-centered competencies. Subsumed under this area are 97 sub-competencies. The second feature is its four stages of career development and the third feature is its instructional settings. The Brolin's work evolved and expanded over years and his work and subsequent editions have served as the nucleus programs throughout different countries. The curriculum of Brolin involves teaching in settings of school, home and community. It also encompasses broad view of a career that extends beyond employment to other important roles in life such as being a family member, a citizen and a person with recreational and leisure interests. This curriculum is used throughout the countries to teach special education students skills which facilitate successful transition from schoolwork and independent living. The competencies and sub-competencies have been reviewed and validated by many schools for disabled as important outcomes for living and working successfully in the community. The life-centered career education delivers a strong foundation for future career development and helps to ensure that everyone has the access to the opportunities that the life holds. The major competencies includes the following. Daily living skills. The daily living skills, according to Brolin, teach students to manage day-to-day tasks or routines of living. The students are taught the abilities to manage the regular domestic activities of life. Managing personal finances, selecting and managing a household, caring for personal needs, raising children and meeting marriage responsibilities, buying, preparing and consuming food, buying and caring for clothing, exhibiting responsible citizenship, utilizing recreational facilities and engaging in leisure, getting around the community. Personal social skills. Personal social skills focus on relations with other people. These enhance the self-confidence of the student and help in improving his or her decision-making skills. The personal social skills give them the confidence and composure to engage with other people around them. Gradually, this will help them to take more control of their own lives and reduce the extent to which their choices are determined by others. The students learn to use their initiative and exercise their own freedom of expression in ways appropriate to their environment. They are achieving self-awareness, acquiring self-confidence, achieving socially responsible community behavior, maintaining good interpersonal skills, achieving independence, making adequate decisions and communicating with others. Occupational guidance and preparation. This third foundational element is vital if the students are planning to enter into workplace and establish some sort of career. This part of training is highly oriented to their competencies, helping to ensure that their abilities are well matched to the sort of role they will find fulfilling and interesting. They include knowing and exploring occupational possibilities, selecting and planning occupational choices, exhibiting appropriate work habits and behaviors, seeking, securing and maintaining employment, exhibiting sufficient physical skills and obtaining specific occupational skills. Brawling used the four-stage approach to career development to structure a progression of experiences from elementary school to secondary settings and post-secondary education through services for adults with disabilities. The four stages are the following: career awareness, career exploration, career preparation, and career assimilation. The LCCE modified curriculum. The original LCCE curriculum developed by Dunn E. Brawling is grounded in more than 21 years of research and has undergone several revisions and modifications. It is a sequenced educational system designed to provide special education and other at-risk students with important skills needed to function successfully as productive workers in schools, home, and communities. Many professionals in this field believe that LCCE is the most comprehensive curriculum available in the field. The LCCE curriculum has been widely tested in schools and with students from many countries. Many schools, especially in the United States, have adopted Brawling's curriculum as their functional transitional special education curriculum. The Council for Exceptional Children has now published the modified version of Brawling's LCCE. This was formulated as an immediate need since many follow-up studies and expert opinion reveal the difficulty adults with moderate disabilities have in achieving successful and appropriate levels of adult community living and working. The major difference of the original LCCE curriculum and the modified one is that the latter focuses on the critical skills and outcomes that individuals with moderate disabilities need. Another significant difference is that attention to both needed support and participation levels is embedded into the curriculum activities. Each subcompetency includes activities that the trainer will address with each individual to encourage him or her to seek assistance and support when needed. The modified version of the LCCE is an extension and revised version of the original. The original LCCE had 22 competencies, 102 subcompetencies, and 3 to 8 objectives for each subcompetency. The revision of the original LCCE in 1982 led to minor changes in a couple of competencies. The 102 subcompetencies were reduced to 97. In the original LCCE, there are totally 425 total objectives. Though many professionals in this field tried to modify the original LCCE, most of them felt that a standalone field validate curriculum program would be more effective and beneficial to this special segment of population. This resulted in the LCCE to design a research to study the feasibility and appropriateness of modifying the original LCCE curriculum. The research study was designed to find out the following purpose: determine whether the sample felt the need to modify the original version of LCCE curriculum, determine the necessary modifications that are necessary to make the curriculum more appropriate. The respondents who assisted the research and people who were familiar with this special segment of people were given an opportunity on the survey to analyze the appropriateness of the original LCCE curriculum and then suggest necessary modifications. Almost 94% of the respondents felt that there is need to modify the original LCCE curriculum. Based on the findings, major modifications were made to Brawling's curriculum in the first round survey. A second round survey based on the modifications was prepared and administered to 150 selected first round respondents. The analysis of this round resulted in minor revisions. This revised version was then presented to a panel of experts in the field for further review. They further suggested some minor revisions, which resulted in the current LCCE modified curriculum. The modified LCCE consists of the following competencies: daily living skills, managing money, selecting and maintaining living environments, caring for personal health, developing and maintaining appropriate intimate relationships, eating at home and in community, cleaning and purchasing clothes, participate in leisure recreational activities, getting around in community, etc. Personal social skills, acquiring self identity, exhibiting socially responsible behavior, developing and maintaining appropriate social relationships, exhibiting independent behavior, making informed decision, communicating with others. Occupational guidance and preparation, exploring and locating occupational training and job placement opportunities, making occupational and job placement choices, applying for and maintaining occupational training and job placements, developing and maintaining appropriate work skills and behavior, matching physical manual skills to occupational training and employment, training and occupational choices. Effective use of the curriculum guide. The effective instruction with the use of the curriculum guide depends on certain factors. It also depends on the teacher taking a flexible approach with their student. The student, when working towards the objectives, should get all the support that they need in order to achieve them. Success, even in little things, must be recognized and acknowledged, as this continues to build confidence in them. The following things should be taken care of when using the guide: using age appropriate materials, teaching for generalization, utilizing individual strengths and weaknesses, utilizing home and community supports, providing instruction in integrative and natural community environments, actively involving and empowering the individual in the development and implementation of his or her functional individual education program and instructional program, implementing self-advocacy strategies, training and activities, actively involving family members and community supports. Let me summarize the session. Education systems are encountering challenges and changes everywhere. The vital importance of education cannot be denied for any individual, but education usually becomes critical for those with any kind of disability, since they are excluded from the mainstream educational process. They experience inequalities in their daily lives and have fewer opportunities to access a quality education that takes place in an inclusive environment. Every student with a disability has the right to an appropriate education in the least restrictive environment. When this special segment of people is given the proper environment, quality instruction and support, they learn both academic and non-academic skills. The field of special education has moved from a perspective of caretaking and protecting to an expectation of learning and growth. A primary purpose of special education is to help students with disabilities to lead successful and personally fulfilling lives. The LCE or LCCE is a competency-based approach designed to address the needs of children with learning disabilities, those with mild mental disabilities, and those children who are at risk. Life-centered education include various training programs that provide education and special training to develop various skills that are useful to this challenged segment of society. Now, you can try to answer the questions given here. What are the difficulties faced by specially challenged group of people in their daily lives? Explain the curriculum and instructional approaches of Jean-Marc Itard. What is Brolin's life-centered education? What are the three important features of the LCC model developed by Brolin? What changes were made in the revised curriculum of LCC? Hope that you may go through the reference books for further understanding. Transition Planning for Students with Disabilities, written by Becken J.P. and Obiaker F.E. in the year 2008, published by Charles C. Thomas Publishers Limited. Enhancing Diversity, written by Anderson R.J. and Keller C.E. and Karp J.M. in the year 1998, published by Gallaudet University Press 1998. Curriculum Development for Students with Mild Disabilities, written by John C.J. in the year 2010, published by Charles Thomas Publishers Limited. Thank you for watching this program. We will meet again with another topic. Till then, take care.